film score students. Ron Sadoff, who is the director of film scoring, is with us. Ron, thank you so much for being here and supporting this. This is, we started off with a contemporary music ensemble, collaborating with film composers. We do this with our NYU orchestra program, and we've expanded it to include the percussion ensemble. So tonight's a wonderful celebration of some wonderful composers and outstanding musicians to play their pieces. Hope you enjoy the evening. Thank you.
We will, for the first time, have AI that can do much more than people can do right now on their own. And we will realize that the majority of physical resources are not confined to a rather small biosphere. In our solar system, there is a lot of material that can be used to build robots. We can develop robots, transmitters, and receivers that will allow AI to be sent to the same space.
Well, at least I think in a second, I think there are five.
The bottom line is that people who talk about
doing safety engineering. Is when you think through everything that can go wrong, so that you can guarantee that it goes right. That's how we successfully send people to the moon safely, and that's how we're successfully going to send our species into an inspiring future with AI. I'm optimistic that we can create a truly inspiring future with advanced artificial intelligence.
Yes.
center. We're going to find a home here. I really like this room. Really great place to play for all of you, make music. We're on the sixth floor of this astonishingly new performing arts center that NYU has constructed in support of instrumental performance, composition, dance, and theater. And I hope you're enjoying as much as we are enjoying the environment that we're in, supporting the fantastic music that we're hearing tonight. And also a special recognition to Sean Statzer, who joins me in both the conductorial duties as well as arranging all of the helping arrange the music and the students and the rehearsal schedule. So Sean, our thanks and appreciation.
And is it technology that's causing us to feel lonely, or do we go to technology because we feel lonely and we seek out sort of technology as a way to feel connected or find people like us?
So when I started my research, I was agnostic about the role that technology and social media played in today's loneliness crisis. But the more I dug into the academic literature, and there's by now, of course, a vast body of this, the more I came to believe that technology was net a problem here. Up until about a year and a half ago, it was hard to actually establish definitively whether it was just correlation that people who were lonely were spending more time, for example, on social media, or was it causative? And there was a landmark study that was carried out by Stanford University about a year and a half ago, a real gold standard of a study that they had 3,000 participants, 1,500 in a control group, and the other 1,500 were expressly charged to go off, in this case, Facebook. And the results were very clear. The group who went off Facebook for 2 months were significantly less lonely, significantly happier, and interestingly spent significantly more time doing things in person with friends and family. So it wasn't that they just migrated onto other platforms. Kids in our phones, not even really hearing them, not present with them. And there was a study where they put a smartphone on a table between a couple, even when the smartphone was turned off, even when neither person was touching the smartphone, the couple felt less empathetic towards each other and less connected. And so there's lots and lots of research on why technology net is making us feel less connected to each other, although I'm actually quite optimistic about the role that social robots and virtual assistants will be able to play in alleviating loneliness. And in my research, I've kind of looked into this a lot, and one example is an Israeli startup. It's a company called LEQ. They have a social robot specifically designed for elderly people, and during the heights of the COVID pandemic, they shipped thousands of these LEQ robots to the United States. And the stories of people who were holed up, isolating, self-isolated, saying, I would be feeling so lonely if I hadn't found a companion in my LEQ. And of course, we know from Japan, where this has been going on for much longer, that people can become very attached to their robot friends and carers, even knitting bonnets for them in elderly people's homes.
So it doesn't mean that we need to have a relationship with people to feel less lonely. Go deeper on that.
So that's a very interesting and important question. How I see it is that on an individual level,
Invited out for an evening and had to turn it down because you're expecting an extra special caller? Well, the electronic central office will solve that problem for you too. When you do go out, it's a simple matter to have your calls transferred. All you'll have to do is dial a special code, which tells the equipment brain why your call is transferred, and then dial a telephone number where you can be reached. Our amazing electronic central office will take it from there. Call you when your line is busy. We thought of that too. Bye. conference call while you take a second.
Oh, hello, dear. I was just talking to Sarah.
I see.
Okay, dear, but you tell Fred next time he's in town, he's to bring Helen, right?
Fine, dear.
You flip the button back and go on with your first call.
Hello, Sarah? That was Bert
calling. It is pie, isn't it? And here's another feature you're going to find handy. Now look,
Sarah Jane knows a lot more about that than I do. Why don't we get her on the line and find out? Okay, just a minute.
Want someone else on the line? That's easy too. Flip the switch button, then dial a code number and the number you want, and press them.
Mentors and teachers within this program. Jackie, all best of luck, but please, you'll come back often. And Tom Dosey, who you never see because he's somewhere in the background, also has been a tremendous help to all of us to get these rooms going, to be able to stream tonight and create these concerts that I think have many dimensions and collaborations that really make NYU sincerely one of the finest programs in the world. And it's a great honor for me to be involved with all of this. So here we go, trip to the moon. Thank you. Percussion Ensemble concert. I'm not sure if you can see the tears welling up in their eyes or the glee in that having been in our program, but everyone who has been with us graduating, congratulations. Thank you so much for what you've brought to the program. And everybody, we're going to keep going and keep playing great music composed by great composers. Great. Everybody have a wonderful summer, and we'll see you in the fall.